the best way to cast your device or receive the screen using the AirSync app is to install what we call the AirSync Sender app on your device. Now, if you don't know where to get this, you'll notice in the AirSync program on the left, there's this little tiny button over here that says Download Sender App. If I click that, what it's gonna do is it's going to give me a website where I can go download the program for, say, my Chromebook or my Windows laptop or even my iPad, or I can just scan the QR code to directly get the app. Now, it's important to note that if you want to be able to use casting features, say on an Android or a iOS device, we definitely recommend using the app as you can't use the system browser for casting. So I already have the AirSync Sender app installed here on my Windows laptop. So let's go ahead and open it really quickly. And what you're gonna notice here when we open the app is there's a portion to enter the display code and the password. That's what's showing right here is the display code and the password. Now, when we're using the AirSync app, if you are on the same network as the device that's casting, so this view board here is on the same network as my laptop, I actually don't have to type in the display code and the password. I can simply go to this device list and it will show all of the devices that are on the network. So the way that I know what this device is you'll see up here, it says AirSync 87645, and I can see that device here in the list. So I'm gonna select it, and then I'm gonna click the next button. Now you'll notice I have two options. I can share or receive. We're just gonna talk about sharing right now because I'm gonna project my screen up. So what I do is I select the share button. I'm gonna get a confirmation here. It says 3763 would like to share. You can see here that the number is also 3763. I'm gonna choose accept. And then you're gonna get a notification on your laptop that you can either share your entire screen, a specific window, or what's called screen extension. And screen extension just lets you run extended desktop, right? So you can have one screen on your laptop and then another screen on the board. We're gonna keep it simple and just share our entire screen. Make sure you actually click on the screen you're sharing and then choose the share button. Now, when this starts connecting, you're gonna see that it's mirrored. And you're gonna have this AirSync Sender window open. It's very important that this window stays open. If this closes, then the connection will disconnect. You'll notice there's a stop button so you can stop the cast, or you can pause it. The pause button is helpful if you need to do something quickly on your laptop and you don't want it to show on the screen, but you can resume it and you don't lose your connection. You'll also notice that there's a pen tool. This just gives you annotation tools, so while you're casting, you can annotate on your documents. But most important is you'll see this button here that says allow touchback. Now this is unique to Windows and MacBook computers. If this was an iPad casting or an Android or even a Chromebook, I wouldn't have this option. But if you are using Windows or MacBook, you can actually touch and interact with your device, but you have to turn this allow touchback toggle on. So I'm gonna come over to my laptop. I'm going to allow touchback. And now you'll see here that I can touch and interact with my laptop while it's casting. So as long as that's running, I'll be able to cast and present my device. If I want to disconnect, I can either disconnect from the board. You'll see here there's a stop button on the screen, or I can simply go over to my laptop. I can open the AirSync and then I can click the stop button and then that will disconnect. So quick review with the AirSync program open, find the download button on the left, go to the website or scan the QR code, download the AirSync Sender app for your device. And then if it's on the same network, you can choose the device from the device list. If it's not, you can just type in the code and then you'll instantly be ready to cast.